The RX 9070 XT is AMD Radeon's most popular GPU since, like, ever. And for good reason. It's a powerful GPU, which trades blows with NVIDIA's last-gen flagship, the RTX 4080, and NVIDIA's current-gen RTX 5070 Ti, with an MSRP much lower than either of those offerings from NVIDIA. I just wish it was actually available for its $600 MSRP, but me whining about the price isn't going to change anything. And you came here to see what the 9070 XT can do in VR, so let's get to it. I started out my testing running the 9070 XT through the Unigen Superposition VR benchmark. I set the per eye resolution to 2064 by 2208, which is the per eye resolution of the Quest 3, which is the headset I use for all my testing, and set the shaders to VR Future and the textures to High. At these settings, the 9070 XT scored a 5-run average of 4989.6, with an average frame rate of 56.13 FPS. To give you something to compare that to, I ran the same benchmark with the 7900 GRE, the RTX 4070 Super, and the RTX 4080, which scored 4496.4, 3971.8, and 5644.4, respectively, with an average frame rate of 50.59, 44.68, and 63.5. While the score difference of roughly 655 points seems like a pretty sizable margin, in terms of FPS, there's only about 7 FPS difference between the RTX 4080 and the 9070 XT in this benchmark, so they're actually fairly closely matched. Sadly, I don't own any RTX 5000 cards to compare the 9070 XT to, but if you'd like to help me buy one, consider dropping me a few bucks with a super thanks.
Do it.
Superposition is just a synthetic benchmark, though. What we really want to know is how the 9070 XT performs in real VR games. So I started off with Beat Saber, and performance was amazing. I was able to play at 4704 by 2528 at 120 Hz, with the render scaling in Beat Saber maxed out at 1.8. We did come kinda close at times to running out of performance headroom at these settings, but ultimately the 9070 XT made it through and delivered a top-notch experience of crisp, sharp visuals and butter-smooth gameplay. This trend continued in the next 6 games I tested, where I was able to run the render resolution in the Questlink app at 4704 by 2528 and the refresh rate at 120 Hz, all while maxing out, or very nearly maxing out, the settings in each game. This included shooters like Contractors, Pavlov, and Breachers, as well as adventure games Red Matter 2, The Walking Dead Saints and Sinners, and of course, Half-Life Alyx. It's kind of hard to believe we're now 5 years on from the release of Half-Life Alyx, and it's still one of the best looking, if not the best looking, VR game out there. The good news is, the 9070 XT delivers an incredible experience in Half-Life Alyx. I mean, look at this. I'm running the game using the ultra-fidelity graphical preset at 120 Hz, and we still have almost 50% of our performance headroom remaining. It's pretty epic. For anyone who's curious about the hardware I'm using in my test setup, you can find my full PC specs as well as headset information in the video description. The 9070 XT delivered great performance in Blade and Sorcery at nearly maxed out settings. I did end up running this one at 90 Hz rather than 120 though, because while I still had a lot of performance headroom here, those of you who are fans of this game know when you get into fights with lots of enemies and you're casting spells with lots of effects, that additional headroom gets eaten up and the game can get a bit choppy. At 90 Hz, using the settings listed on screen, the game looked great and played smoothly throughout all of my testing. Lone Echo 2 is another gorgeous game, and it's a shame that Meta closed down Ready at Dawn, the studio behind it. But if you're curious how well the 9070 XT runs Lone Echo 2, here's the settings I used. I kept the render resolution at 4704 by 2528 and set the refresh rate to 90 Hz. As for the game settings, most were at their highest value, but I did set the shadow quality to medium and turned MSAA off. As you can see here, even in the game's most graphically demanding areas, I was able to maintain performance headroom above 20%, so there was never any worry about the frame rate dropping below 90. Like Lone Echo 2, I ran into the radius at 4704 by 2528 at 90 Hz, and probably could have pushed the in-game settings up a bit more than I did, but I was happy with the way the game looked and played at these settings. And this is one of those games where it's always good to leave yourself a good amount of performance headroom, because there are certain areas and enemy encounters that cut into that headroom. And a consistently smooth VR experience is always better than one that is sometimes choppy. Speaking of VR experiences that sometimes get a bit choppy, the next game I tested was Ghosts of Tabor. This is one of those games, it seems, no matter what settings I used, it would run great with tons of performance headroom in some areas, but then completely crap out in others. I spent multiple hours trying to dial settings in on this one, and in the end settled on what you're seeing on screen now, which still resulted in asynchronous space warp kicking in from time to time, which you can see here when the app frame rate drops to 45 FPS. Sure, I could have lowered the render resolution some more or lowered game settings, but this game isn't exactly the most visually impressive game I've ever played, and I wanted to at least get it looking as nice as I could while also keeping our frame rate above 90 as much as possible. So yeah, these settings don't offer a flawless experience with the 9070 XT, but overall it was pretty good. For Assetto Corsa Competizione, I turned down the render resolution in the Questlink app to 4480 by 2400, but kept the refresh rate at 90 Hz. And while this list of in-game settings is stupidly long, I actually just enabled the VR High preset, which sets all these settings to the listed levels. I totally suck at sim racing, but the 9070 XT, on the other hand, does not. We were pretty close to the limits of what the 9070 XT can do in this game at these settings, but it hung in there nicely and delivered good-looking visuals and a pretty great driving experience. Last but certainly not least, we have Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020, and this is probably the game the 9070 XT impressed me with the most. For those that have seen my GPU VR performance videos before, you know I always test Flight Simulator with the in-game settings at their lowest values, which I again did this time as well. And what impressed me is how the 9070 XT was able to maintain a nearly constant 72 FPS at 4480 by 2400, not only in this training flight over Sedona, Arizona, but also in the Discovery flight over New York City. There were a few moments where the performance headroom dropped below zero, but for the most part, the 9070 XT chugged right through this test without an issue. This then made me want to see what would happen if I turned the in-game settings up to ultra, so I gave it a go. This did cause asynchronous space warp to kick in and dropped our app frame rate down to 36 FPS. But it was a very consistent 36 FPS, so while the frame rate was low, it didn't feel choppy. It's my understanding this is what many VR pilots do anyway. They'll push the settings up as high as they can while still maintaining a frame rate like this. In the Sedona, Arizona training flight, there was quite a bit of shimmering when I'd look out at the houses and other buildings in the distance, which doesn't really show up in this capture. But I'm sure the VR pilots out there know what I'm talking about, and it's not exactly the most pleasant thing. The level of detail going to ultra adds inside the aircraft in the environment is pretty awesome though. Even in the New York City flight, the 9070 XT churned out a constant 36 FPS, which I found pretty impressive. There was a little fuzziness, or ghosting I guess I'll call it, from using reprojection, but it wasn't at all a bad experience. Overall, I feel the 9070 XT is a great GPU, and while it is really expensive, when compared to its direct competition, it is a pretty decent value. Assuming you can find one at MSRP, of course. At the time I'm making this video, it's been nearly 5 months since the 9070 XT launched, and the least expensive ones I can currently find are going for $720 US, so a full $120 above AMD's advertised MSRP. Just how long this pricing is going to last, who knows. But if you already own a 9070 XT and are here simply to find out what kind of VR performance you can expect out of it, then I hope this video has you excited to jump in and do some gaming. And for those of you who are currently shopping for a new GPU and want to see what the VR performance of other GPUs out there are like, then this playlist here hopefully has what you're looking for. Come on, do it. You know you want to. Subscribe.
Do it.